Whenever Richard Cory went downtown, we people on the pavement looked at him. He was a gentleman from sole to crown, clean favored, and imperially slim. And he was always quietly arrayed, and he was always human when he talked, but still he fluttered pulses when he said, "Good morning," and he glittered when he walked. And he was rich, yes, richer than a king, and admirably schooled in every grace. In fine, we thought that he was everything to make us wish that we were in his place. So on we worked, and waited for the light, and went without the meat, and cursed the bread. And Richard Cory, one calm summer night, went home and put a bullet through his head.
Well, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, everyone. Honorable Mr. Tuntun Sinaga, honorable all of my friends, hopefully we are always in a good condition. Tabi pun. Okay, in this special occasion, we would like to present a topic related to the poetry. This group consists of, the first is Arif Alexander, the second is Faradina Primarini, the third is Indah Rizkia Putri, and then Rini Putri Malinda, and the last one is Triwidyoko. Okay, in this presentation will be divided into 5 parts. The first one is about problem in teaching EFL learners in Indonesia and the literature. The second one is about literature in curriculum 2013. And then the third is about poetry. The fourth is about narrative poetry and the consideration. And the last one is about lesson plan. Okay, let's get started. Okay, we come to the first part. It is about problem in teaching English as a foreign language in Indonesia. Here we go. English has been considered to be the first foreign language in Indonesia. English has been taught in Indonesia since the era of Dutch colonial period. At the time, the access of education for the locals was very rare. And according to the expert, Lauder, 2008, English was first taught to Indonesians in 1914 when junior high schools were established. And how about now? Nowadays, English functions to help the development of the state and nation, to build relations with other nations, and to run foreign policy, including as a language used for wider communication in international forum. And in relation to that, Indonesia has been carrying out teaching English foreign language in almost level of schools, starting to be taught in the basic primary school until secondary school. And since it is only a foreign language, of course, there are a lot of problems found in English language learning. Here, the problems in applying or teaching English as a foreign language, like lack of motivation, poor scheduled time, not enough resources and materials, and the excess of students in each classroom. There are undoubtedly some of the problems that the teacher have to face in teaching English as a foreign language. Related to the resources, inadequate resources and materials also bring complexity in English language teaching.
researches and materials here refer to a wide range of objects that can be used for teaching, such as models, cards, computers, sound labs, and so on and so forth. They play important role during teaching learning process, for they represent elements in the real world meant to help students understand and explain reality. In other words, they are helpful to change something complex to be simple. Here the example. When the teacher wants to teach about animals, it will be rather difficult to have the students understand what it's like only by words. Of course, it needs sources and materials to help students more easy to understand the thing that the teacher explained. So, if the teachers provide little resources and materials, of course, it will make English become much more complicated to the students. And to overcome these problems, the responsibility of the educational system is needed. However, the teacher also have to use their creativity to be aware of the limitation and constraints, and collectively make an effort to address and find way to deal with the frustration this problem bring about. Next is about literature. One of the alternative resources or materials in teaching language learning is by using literature. Through the use of literature, a language learning experience might become at the same time a source of immediate pleasure and satisfaction for the students. This possibility makes literature an appealing teaching device for ESL learners. It is from Arthur, 2006. Furthermore, the use of literature in English classrooms makes the learners focus on meaning. This from Murao, 2009. And it is kind of vehicle for engaging learners with language. In this sense, language becomes a means for its own real function. It is not just a means for practice. Language becomes a means in the hands of learners and manipulated by them to use their background knowledge to understand authentic texts. And here are the features of literature. There are four here. The first is language enrichment. The second is cultural enrichment, authentic material, and the last is personal involvement. As a language enrichment, texts of literary works describe things which mattered to the author when he or she wrote them. Compared to the language samples in the textbook, the language is far richer and more varied. By asking students to explore the literary language, they will be encouraged to familiarize themselves with different language use, forms, or conventions. And the second is cultural enrichment. Literature also is a doorway into another culture, giving students the opportunity to eventually understand and appreciate cultures and ideologies different from their own. Students also can come to perceive traditions of thought, feeling, and artistic form within the heritage, the literature of such cultures and those. The third one is authentic material. Literary texts so often touch on common themes and values which range from individual concerns to social issues such as death, love, pollution, ethnic conflict, and etc. Even the genres, conventions, and devices portrayed are universal. Poetry has rhythm, rhyme, and figurative language use. Moreover, literature includes all possible varieties of subject matter and language which might be intrinsically interesting. The texts are non-trivial because they cover many significant themes and contexts which are missing in most EFL textbook. Literature exposes students to fresh themes and unexpected language. In this sense, a literary text is authentic text, real language in context, to which we can respond directly. It is from Bramfield and Carter, 1986. And the last is personal involvement. Students may relate the ideas, events, and things found in the literary text to their own lives. It will be helpful to stimulate the imagination of our students, to develop their critical abilities, and to increase their emotional awareness. It also develops learners' pleasure in reading. When EFL learners enjoy reading literature and have motivation to interact with the text, I think they will develop their reading proficiency. When they try to comprehend the meaning of the text, learners must make inferences, drawing both on content of the reading and their own experience. Furthermore, literature has a wider function because it fosters personal development in the readers. It helps learners to grow as individuals as well as in their relationship with the people and the institutions around. This is a crucial part of an education which might not be offered by the textbook. So we can conclude that the use of literature yields many benefits. The most important justification is that literature can educate the whole person. This is opinion from Lazard in 1993. Okay, that's all of my part. It will be continued by the next presenter. Thanks.
Okay, good afternoon everyone. My name is Indah Rizkia Putri Warganegara. I am the second presenter of Poem Group. So here I would like to explain about literature in ELT curriculum. As we know that Indonesia now use 2013 curriculum, and the presence of 2013 curriculum is a refinement of the previous curriculum. And in this curriculum, language learning is offered to students aimed at training language skill learners by expressing their ideas creatively and also critically. And how about literature in ELT curriculum? Is it important or not for students to learn? So as we know that literature is believed to be beneficial for ELT learners, and ELT students can benefit from the role of literature in promoting among other things, like for example language acquisition and also language proficiency. And the potential benefits of introducing literature in ELT classroom seem to have been forgotten in recent ELT curriculum. The examination of ELT textbooks from the 2013 curriculum used for teaching ESL to Indonesian senior secondary school students is in favor of this position. Only books aimed for students majoring in language programs contain literary works. So why literature is important for students in ELT? Due to the richness of characters in literature, which represent among others the writer's imagination, portraits of social life, and the suffering of humans living their lives, The use of literature can have many benefits for learners of English. It is also supported by Colley and Slater 1987 and also Slater 1993. They are argued that literature can help learners understand another culture or cultural enrichment and provide stimulus for language acquisition or language enrichment. Besides this, as most literary works are not written for special use in the classroom, literature can also expose learners to authentic materials. And we know that literature also has been believed to be beneficial in ELT since one of its benefits is purposed to be the development of critical thinking. When ELT is infused with critical thinking pedagogy, there will be two advantages, especially for students. The first one, students may improve their language proficiency. Second one is students' critical thinking skills may be enhanced. However, as has been mentioned, literary criticism is getting unpopular in ELT curriculum due to possibly the influence of the communicative approach. Gosen 2002 states that using literature in the ELT classroom has potential for promoting empathy and tolerance, which could decrease prejudice. Unfortunately, recent ELT programs have very little attention to this aspect. And in the context of ELT, literature brings many very positive effects in such aspects as language proficiency and critical thinking. And conditions in Indonesia need people who can appreciate different points of view, thus promoting tolerance. Therefore, retaining literature in Indonesian ELT curriculum may help bring about three important positive effects. The first one, literature can make students have better language proficiency. And second one, literature can improve ability in critical thinking. And the last one, literature can increase tolerance to each other. That's all about my presentation. The next presentation will be presented by Alex. Thank you for your attention.
Hello, today I will present about my part about poetry and its challenge by me, Arif Alexander Bastian, based on calendar that relates in Indonesia challenge. One of the literary activities that can help students in learning English in ELT classroom is learning poetry. What is poetry? Poetry is all words that represent the author's feelings and experience from the expert. For example, Olila and Jantas 2006 state that poetry is a kind of verbal or written language that is structured rhythmically, and it's meant to tell a story or express any kind of emotion, idea, or state of being, and it used to achieve this artistic expression in several ways. Students can share their ideas and stories through the learning poetry. By learning poetry, students can improve for language skill. They can improve their listening, reading, also writing. Especially, they can speak about poetry. By listening and reading poetry, students can exercise both skill in order to guess meaning and exercise to listen in the words in English. Moreover, they can write other poems that are related to their experience. By reading a poem, students can improve the language aspect such as grammar and vocabulary. After writing a poem, they can show up their writing in front of the class. This activity helps them to develop intonation, self-confidence, gesture, and emotion, especially in speaking skills. Although there are many advantages integrating poetry in ELT classroom, teachers should know the challenges in implementing poetry activities and how they overcome with these challenges. Now, I want to tell you about the challenges related with calendar. Next. Yeah, that's calendar 2011 state that in foreign language teaching, Teaching poetry is a challenge for teachers and students because they or both of them should have extra thinking to get the meaning of poem that they read and read, especially if it is written in foreign language, especially in English. In here, Kalender will describe four challenges in teaching and learning poetry in ELT classroom that relates with us in Indonesia. First, we can see teachers and students should have extra thinking to get the meaning of poems they read. Teachers and students get difficulty because of linguistic aspects. Some students feel bored in reading poetry because they cannot get the benefits from this activity. Next, teacher do not have the confidence to struggle, bear all or take such as teaching. And last, teachers sometimes do not know the level of their students. They just keep the material without considering student level. So it's difficult for students to know the meaning of the poem because they don't understand about the concept of poem. They don't know. First, for me, they don't have the brainstorming or like a schemata what is the poem they have read before. So in here, teacher should have an extra or extra thinking to transfer the meaning of poem. Because if the student know the meaning of that poem, I think reading poetry is really amazing, or they can relate with their life and they can increase about their writing skill. They can relate their experience with the poem. So I think that's all about my part about the poetry and the challenges. Okay, I think that's all. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Faridina. I'm the third presenter of my group, Poetry Group. And I would like to continue the presentations. First, I will explain about narrative poetry. Narrative poetry is the oldest forms of poetry. Long before there was a paper to write on or ink to write with or the invention of printing press, people often share the story or spread the story as a form of entertainment. And in the same way, like nowadays, where we spread the story, news or historical event through newspaper, for example, people back then, oral story were used to spread the news or historical event. And in order to help recall the story, people often make use of rhythm or rhyme in order to give musical quality back then, to allow the story to be remembered or recall more easily. And that's how narrative poetry was originally created. And narrative poetry is a poetry that tells the story. It has beginning that tells or introduce the background to the setting, the middle that tells the actions of the events, and the last one, the end, which concludes or summarizes the story. And according to Mayer 2012, when the students read narrative poetry, they not only get to read some amazing story, but they can also practice their reading comprehensions and writing skills. And then when students read narrative poetry, this narrative poetry offers the students opportunities to identify the story element plot structure, mood, and theme, and then summarize what they have read. In addition, when students write narrative poetry, they can also practice their writing skills that they would use when writing any type of narrative fictions or non-fictions. And for these students, narrative poetry may be an easier or more enjoyable options than lyric or dramatic poetry, rather than they have to struggle with a hidden meaning in the poetry. They enjoy narrative poetry because there is story in it, and there are several characteristics that narrative poetry has. The first one, narrative poetry is told from the point of view of a main character, a witness to the event in the story, or a person who is retelling the story he or she heard from another person. And the second one, like other poetry, narrative poetry make use of imagery, figurative language, and sound patterns. And then the third one, narrative poetry usually begins with an exposition that describe the main characters or the settings of the story in the poetry. And the fourth one, narrative poetry is used to entertain, not to express the food, feelings, or talk. It means that the purpose of the narrative poetry is to entertain. And then the fourth one, narrative poetry tells a story in a more condensed way than prose, or in a simple way rather than prose. And the last one, narrative poetry can be fictional or non-fictional. And the poetry that we use in our task here in our group is Richard Cory. That's the title, Richard Cory. It was written by Edwin Arlington Robinson, and he was a poet in New England poet of America in the 19th century. And the Richard Cory poetry is one of the famous poetry that he had written. And Richard Cory is a poetry that tells a man that seems to have it all, everything that people want. And then the people of the town who are clearly in this poetry are lower financial class, few poetry in a highway, because people there think that Richard Cory had everything they want. And then actually this poetry, the central idea of the poetry is that wealth and status do not answer happiness, because in the end of the poetry, Richard Cory killed himself. It means that appearance, money, status do not answer happiness, and what people think about him are actually not true, because people Richard Cory killed himself, and because he was unhappy, and that's why we choose this poetry, because it has a moral value there, and then it also has a culture context there. And the considerations, actually, this is the consideration. This poetry is easy to read, and the language tends to be simple and direct. And then Richard Cory enables the students to go beyond what is written into what is mean. It means that the students, when reading Richard Corey, they have to understand what is written there. For example, why Richard Corey killed himself, even he had everything, he was rich, and then several words there, what is the meaning actually of the word there used. And then the second one is this poetry teaches students some moral value, like money, status, appearance do not answer happiness, and also do not reflect realities. And then the second one, this poetry is able to detail the life of Richard Corey as a person of the upper social class in America, and how people from the lower class or middle social class there view him. It means that Richard Corey give a brief view back then in how people from lower class view Richard Corey as the gentleman of the upper class, upper social class in America. And then the last one is, this poetry can enrich students' vocabulary, because text for example that the students has to because in this poetry, like for example, from soul to crown, what does it mean? It enrich their vocabulary. Instead of using from head to toe, they can use from soul to crown, for example. And then it is in line with the calend. Among other reasons, poetry is a source of content-rich reading material, a model of creative language in use, a way to introduce vocabulary in context. A content-rich reading material, we assume here that in Richard Corey, it not only has a, let's say, a moral value, but it also tells about the culture of how people from lower class people view person from the upper class. And then the second one, creative language in use, that like he said, whenever Richard Corey is downtown, that it means that is coming down, he used Edwin Arlington Robinson used downtown. And then performance here, like a way to introduce vocabulary in context. A performance here is for lower class people, and it is a it describe a lower class people. And then richer than a king, it means that Richard Corey is rich. And you have to remember or mention that Richard Corey, it means that rich, it means that he's rich. From the name also, the poet can give the view that Richard Corey is already rich from his name, rich. And then from soul to crown, like I said before, rather than use from head to toe, and then put the bullet on his head, instead using shoot his head, the put use put the bullet on his head. And that's why we use Richard Corey poetry in our group. And that's all from my presentations, and I'm sorry if for the mistakes I made, and for the mistake I made and unclear explanation, for example. And I hope that all of you enjoy or can get a few from my group about poetry and narrative poetry especially. And thank you very much.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, my friends, my name is Rini Malinda. Here I want to continue my group presentation and I want to tell you the lesson plan of using POM. Okay, the lesson plan is for junior high school in pre-intermediate level. And then the time is 90 minutes. Now after that, the focus is for vocabulary and writing. And then the objective of this lesson plan is students are able to identify the antonym of word from the poem. And then students are able to write a short poem by choosing one topic that given by the teacher. And then the media that teacher use in the this lesson plan is paper, video, and board. Okay, next to the pre-activity, first the teacher greets the students and check attendance list. After that, the teacher engage the learners in small talk to ease the tension to attract their attention. After that, the teacher asks the students some questions related to the poem. For example, like, do you ever read a poem? What kind of a poem that you ever read? Or do you know the purpose of the poem? Something like that. After that, the teacher lets students share their ideas. And then, the teacher mentions the learning objective for the lesson. Okay, next to the mind activity, first the teacher play a video of narrative poem and ask the learner to watch it. After that, the teacher elicit 15 words related to the poem on the board. For example, like handsome, gentleman, rich, beautiful, and among others. After that, in pairs, the students are asked to create categories to put all the word into. After that, on a paper folded in half, the students are then given one stanza of the poem with gapped word. Next, in pairs, the students guess the missing words, and then the teacher reads the stanza aloud. And then there are also the YouTube video of people reciting the poem. Next, the students and teacher discuss together about the missing word. And then the students are asked to find the antonym from the underlined word in the poem. Okay, next, students and teacher discuss the antonym of the word together. And then the teacher elicit which of the word from the brainstorm activity during the mind activity apply to this poem. How are they related? It's usually surprising how many of their words link in some way to this one single stanza. Okay, next to the last activity or post activity, here the teacher and the students discuss about the problem during the lesson. After that, the teacher asks some students to share their opinion about the poem, and then the teacher gives feedback to the students. And the last, the teacher closed the class by greeting. Okay, my friend, that is the example of lesson plan using POM. Thank you for your attention. I close. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.